up, so if you could go ahead and flip that over, everybody should have a paper. Yesterday we learned about the 13 colonies, and we learned the geography of the original 13 colonies, so this should be a warm-up just to get us in the history mode today. So if you could just go ahead and label each colony, which is today a state, of the name of the colony, and then we'll get started. I'm glad you didn't forget overnight. Alright, it looks like everybody has time to complete the warm-up, so we're going to get started. We're just going to go over this really quickly so that we remember. So our first table right here, you all had the New England colonies, right? Okay, so we're going to start with this colony. So this is kind of a weird colony. It's two states today that have one line and one name. Can someone at that table tell me what colony this was? Massachusetts. Good job. And we remember that today what we know is Maine was also claimed by Massachusetts. So that was kind of a tricky one. So it's good to start with a tricky one. Alright, let's move on to this colony right here. What do you guys think that is? New Hampshire. New Hampshire. I totally touched it. Yeah, so this is New Hampshire. And now let's move down to this really little colony. This really little one right there. What do you guys think that is? Rhode Island, nice. And now we'll finish off the New England colonies with this last colony.
Connecticut.
That's a good way to think about it when you spell it, right? Always say connect, add, cut, and then you remember. Good job. All right, so that is the New England colonies. Now let's move on to the Mid-Atlantic colonies. So that's this table in the back, has the Mid-Atlantic colonies. Can someone tell me what this really big colony is right here from that table?
New York.
New York. Nice, yep. And so if we go right under New York, what is this colony, this square one? Jared?
Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania. And let's move east of Pennsylvania to this one. Becca, do you know what that one is?
New Jersey.
New Jersey, awesome. And now let's finish it out with this really little one on the side. Dakota, do you know what colony that is?
Delaware.
Delaware, nice. So those are all the Mid-Atlantic colonies, New York, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, and Delaware. And now we're going to move on to our southern colonies, which is this table at the back. So to start, what is this colony right here? Maryland. Awesome. How about if we go south of Maryland? This one we all should know. This is an important colony.
Virginia.
Has everybody been to Virginia? No, yeah, some of us haven't. So we all live in Virginia, so Virginia is a very important colony. Alright, what if we go right north, or right south of Virginia? Yes, you said that's North Carolina, that's where I'm from. Ah, okay, so you've been to North Carolina, you're from North Carolina. You were born there, so you'll remember lots of things about North Carolina, and that will be useful later in our discussion. Alright, so what if we go south of North Carolina? South Carolina! Is it an easy way to remember? North Carolina, South Carolina. Alright, let's move on to our last colony. Our last colony, the one at the very bottom. What do you guys think that is?
Georgia.
Georgia, yep. Good job. So now we've gone through all of our colonies. We learned this yesterday, so this is just a refresher. So our purple colonies up here are the New England colonies, which is Massachusetts, New Hampshire, Rhode Island, and Connecticut. We have our blue colonies, which is the Mid-Atlantic colonies, which is New York, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, and Delaware. And then we have our southern colonies down here in green, which is Maryland, Virginia, North Carolina, South Carolina, and Georgia. So we are going to be kind of dividing the regions into these three colonies today, so that's what we're going to talk about. That's what we're going to talk about today. Okay, so our agenda for today, we've already done the warm-up, so you guys did a great job on that. Next, we're going to do our resources and specialization notes, so we're going to learn about the different resources and the different specializations in each region. Then we're going to do a fun poster activity to get you guys creative with markers, so that should be fun. And then we're going to do our That's a Wrap activity to finish off the day. All right, so our SOL today Okay, so our guiding question today is, how did available resources, climate, and geography distinguish the three regions from one another? So we're going to talk about each region and how it was different than all the other regions and what they specialized in, what they were good at. And how did citizens use their resources to survive? So why were these resources important to each colony? So those are going to be our questions we're going to think about today. So today you're going to use geography to understand the perimeter of each colony, which we've done in the warm-up. You guys had a map, we had a map up here, so you learned about the geography of each colony. You'll be able to explain the resources used, so we're going to do that with our notes. And then you can combine this knowledge and distinguish each colony from one another based on their specialization. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and hand out your notes for today. So we're going to talk about different resources and specializations in the 13 colonies. So when you get this, please put your name on the top and the date. And the date is October 17th. All right, does everybody have a worksheet? All right, awesome. Okay, so if you go to the very top of your worksheet, we have natural resources, human resources, and capital resources. We've already talked about the three different types of resources in our Native American unit, and we talked about them in our Explorer unit. So you guys already know the three different types of resources, so I didn't think we would need to fill that out, but I did put it up at the top for you all. So just to go over it again, natural resources are things that come directly from nature. So these are like trees, animals, oceans, farmland, anything that you can go outside and just find is a natural resource. So then human resources are people working to produce goods or services. So any person who is doing a job, like a fisherman, they are a human resource. And then our last one is capital resources, which are goods produced to make other goods. So some examples of these are tools and buildings and anything used to make other resources, the capital resources. So before we get started, we're going to play a game about distinguishing the different types of resources from one another. So I'm going to show some pictures, and you guys are going to have to guess, is it a human resource, a capital resource, or a natural resource? Just to kind of remember the definitions of these, because it has been a while since we've talked about it. So our first picture here, we have a farm, we have some fish, we have people working on a ship. Can anybody raise their hand and tell me what type of resource is this? So we have people working, we have fishing, farming. Mike, what do you think it is? It is a human resource. Good job. So we have a farmer, we have a fisherman, and we have shipbuilders. So all of these are humans. They're people working to produce goods. Good. Thank you. All right. Our next one, we have a farm, we have cows, and oceans, and trees. Can anybody guess what type of resource all these things are? Sam.
A natural resource.
A natural resource. Good job. So why do you think it's a natural resource?
They come from the earth. You can't make the ocean.
Exactly. So you can't make any of these things. They're already all there, right? They're all natural. All right. Our last one, we have some buildings, we have some tools. What kind of resource do you all think you're looking for? We have one left. Earl.
Capital resource.
Capital resource. And why do you think it's a capital resource?
Because that's the capital of Williamsburg.
True. Has anybody been to Williamsburg? Yeah. And what state is that in?
Virginia.
Virginia. And what colony is Virginia in? From New Atlantic, from New England, Mid-Atlantic, or Southern? Which colony is Virginia in?
Southern.
I heard it. Good job. So that representation would be from a Southern colony. Okay, awesome. So we're going to go back and look at our notes. We're going to go down to the middle section of the resources. So if you guys can follow along with me, we're going to talk about all the different types of resources. So we're going to start with the New England colony. So we're going to talk about New England's natural resources. So who remembers what a natural resource is? Right, what's a natural resource?
Something that comes from nature.
Yep, something that comes from nature. Good job. So who can think of a natural resource they would have a lot of in New England? Does anybody have any ideas? They're right by the coast. They have a lot of animals. Jared?
Fish.
Fish! Good! Well, great fish. Good job. Fish are very important in New England. They're very important. Good job. Okay, so if you have a lot of fish, what else do you need when you have fish that could be a natural resource?
Water.
What do fish need to swim in?
Water.
Water. So Harvard. So let's write Harvard. Yeah, so fish need harbors and ships need harbors to dock in order for the fishermen to go out and fish, which is a very major resource for the New England colony. Okay, we have one more. So if you want to go out into a forest, you can get a lot of this supplies to make houses, boats. What kind of resources do you need that? Wood for timber. So fish, harbors, and timbers are the main natural resources in New England. So let's move on to human resources. So for these three natural resources, what kind of workers do you think they would need to have in New England?
Fishermen.
Fishermen, awesome, because someone needs to go out and get the fish, right? So let's write down fishermen. Fishermen were very important. They need fishermen to go out. So, what do you think that the fishermen would need to have to go out and fish? What kind of supplies do they need? A boat. So, who makes boats? Shipbuilders. So, same idea, really good. So, another human resource would be shipbuilders. And I'm also going to add craftsmen. So someone needs to put in shopkeepers, craftsmen, people to sell these resources. Alright, now we're going to move on to capital resources. So we already discussed some examples of capital resources. So what do you guys think would be an example of a capital resource in New England? Ryan.
That place where they put the boat?
Yeah, okay. So I'm going to put building, right? So you need somewhere to put your boat. You need somewhere to sell your fish. So buildings are really important. All right, well, think about another thing that we may have seen a picture of earlier. That could be considered a capital resource. Something that you need to go and catch fish. Nets, and what is a net an example of? Capital resource. Okay, pool. Right, so a net is the type of pool needed to catch fish. Awesome, yeah. So we have pools and buildings for capital resources. And now we are going to move on to specialization. So a specialization is when a colony focuses on one type of product, one or two types of products that they're really good at and that other colonies need them for. So what kind of things do you think New England is really good at producing based on our conversation so far? Boats, yep. So they specialize in boats. And I'm also going to write naval associated with that. Does anybody know what the word naval means? So it could be your belly button, but a lot of words have two different meanings. So one, sometimes naval means belly button. Think about another time that naval can mean something else. Like the Navy. Have you guys heard of the Navy? And the Navy uses boats, ships. So maybe naval means boats and shipping, right? So we also have naval supplies. And so when you go out on a boat, what are you expecting to bring back with you?
Fish.
So another one of their main specializations is fish. All right. Does everybody have this written down? Give you a few seconds to finish up. All right. We are going to move down to the Mid-Atlantic colony. So who remembers what the Mid-Atlantic colony were? What states today make up the Mid-Atlantic colony? Pennsylvania is one. Can someone think of another one?
Delaware
is one. New Jersey. We're missing one more.
New York,
good job. So those are the four Mid-Atlantic colonies, so think about those when we think about their resources today. So for those of you who have been to Pennsylvania or New York, what kind of natural resources have you seen there?
Lots of greenery.
Lots of greenery, yes, like farms maybe. Lots of farms, so we're going to put rich farmland. grow crops for farming. So think about what plants need to provide, and we also need to provide.
Water.
So we also have a lot of rivers, which is another natural resource. So let's move down to human resources. So if there are a lot of rivers, what kinds of jobs could you have in a river? When you're maybe fishing? Captain, like fishermen? So we're going to add fishermen, which we remember from the New England colonies was important. And I'm also going to add workers. And let's talk about our capital resources. So the capital resources are very similar between the three different colonies. So can anybody think of a capital resource that they would need in the Mid-Atlantic colony?
Tools.
Good job. And buildings. So we will see a theme with the capital resources throughout this unit that tools and buildings are very important. Okay, so based on farmlands, rivers, fishermen, what kind of specialization do you think the Mid-Atlantic region would have? Does anybody remember what the word specialization
is? To be good at something.
To be really good at something and to make a profit from something you're really good at. So what do you think the Mid-Atlantic colonies are really good at producing?
Farm things.
What did you say?
Farm things.
Farm things. Good job. So like livestock? So livestock is like cattle, horses, pigs, any animal you find on a farm is livestock. And then also a farm thing, grains. Grains are really important to the Mid-Atlantic colony. And then what about one more specialization that we usually focus on in New England, but we're going to focus on it a little bit in the Mid-Atlantic colonies, that deals with rivers and fishermen, that could be considered a specialization.
Fish.
Awesome. All right. So now we're going to move on to the southern colonies. I'll give you guys a few seconds to wrap this up in your notes. Specialization and crops are really good in the southern. Rice. Tobacco. I heard two good ones.
Cotton.
Indigo. Does anybody know what indigo is? Can you tell me what that is?
It's like a plant that makes a purple dye.
Yep. So you guys know the color indigo, probably from art class. It makes this dark blue purplish dye. That was very popular. So indigo plants were important. Alright, you guys got all of them. Very impressed. So the specializations in the South are rice, tobacco, cotton, and indigo. Okay, so we are going to work on our posters next, and this is going to be a project that we're going to start today, and we're going to finish next class, and we're going to present next class. So each table will represent a different colony, and it'll be the same colony you did your warm-up in. So you already know the geography of the colony, so you should already be ready to go on that. So I'm going to pass out your posters, and you're going to use this time to think about resources that are plentiful in these colonies, and you're going to draw them out on here. So you're going to think about their natural, human, and capital resources, and you're going to draw them. So, like, what is an important resource in New England?
Fish.
So what do you think we could draw in the New England?
Lots of fish.
Lots of fish. Good job. So I'm going to give you guys a few minutes to get started on this today and think about, so you guys can think about ideas, and then we're going to do it tomorrow. Okay, so you can maybe draw a few things now, and then we're going to finish this up tomorrow. All right, does anybody have any questions before we get started?
Yeah.
Wonder Bread. And so how does that relate to the Mid-Atlantic colonies?
Grains.
Grains, awesome. Right, I'm going to leave these out. Don't do anything with them?
Okay.
Nice, yeah, I like it. Based on resources.
And then you can just leave them at your table, and then I'll come collect them.
When on my way out. They're on your way out of the classroom.
Feedback.
come up and not dance on this part. And then that way that they could interact with the notes a little bit. And then that way that you would have that unique piece that Dr. Pickett was talking about with different things that they maybe bring out that really don't really bring out.
Yeah, it was mostly just call and response.
Maybe, like when we were on the Mid-Atlantic, you added workers to what you were saying, but like I kind of wanted to know like what kind of workers, so maybe like if you're going to add something, or like if that's what you want them to know, and like expand on what you want them to know, because they might not know what workers, unless, I mean, I'm sure you'll talk about it later, and we just didn't get that either, but like I felt like I wanted.
Coming up in the right.